The Italians have invaded Abyssinia.
Sir, should we stop it?
No, no action should be taken, for we do not want another world war. What will happen if we intervene?
But we're talking about Italians, they're part of the League.
Well, why
would they be breaking the Treaty of Versailles?
Well, they're possibly for a chance of restoring the Roman Empire.
And what about the Germans? In addition, they have invaded Austria. There have been numerous rumors regarding the Germans have plans to expand their army, including expanding to everywhere else in Europe.
Well, that is definitely a sign to many countries that Germany is attempting to become a major power once more, and there are major threats to the world concerning the German force during the last World War.
Think about it. In the Germans' perspective, we were a little too harsh on them and during the post-war period.
That's an outrage.
The Italian trade dangereuse et pourquoi?
They will gouge on.
The Italians are very dangerous.
No, they're not.
On veut la prospérité.
We want human rights.
Marcotim bezopasniste.
We want freedom.
Before the San Francisco Conference, many events occurred, factoring to the outline of the writing of the United Nations Charter and the founding of the United Nations. Events such as the declaration of St. James Palace on June 12, 1941, to the last event of the Embarkment Oath in Yalta during 1944-1945, led to the final San Francisco Conference.
During the San Francisco Conference, 45 nations including four sponsors were invited to the conference. Representatives from over 80% of the world met together to discuss about the terms that would eventually become the United Nations and the United Nations Charter, which will ensure peace being maintained and a better world will be built.
Member 50 nations excluding Poland. Poland did not have a recognized government until October 15, 1945, therefore becoming one of the original members. But United Nations did not come into existence until October 24, 1945. On this day, United Nations Day is celebrated every year on October 24th.
130 countries participated in peacekeeping. It was often noted to be invented by the Canadians. Canadian peacekeepers began to wear blue berets in 1956 to distinguish themselves from the British peacekeepers. In 1957, Lester B. Pearson, also known as the godfather of modern peacekeeping, was given the Nobel Peace Prize as a recognition for his contributions to the UN. The Reconciliation Monument was created in 1992 to commemorate over 110,000 Canadian peacekeepers.